Hi, welcome back to the cordless vacuum guide, and in this review we'll have a close look at the Roborock S7 auto empty dock. It's been a long wait, but it's finally here, and we'll find out in this video if that wait was worth it. When Roborock unveiled the S7, they also released a teaser of an auto empty base station, and the actual unit isn't far off the render with the same double barrel design, which is a departure from what I've seen in other brands. I've spent the past few days testing this product, examining its features, specifications, and Roborock did add some unique features not found in other auto-empty robots, which we'll look at later. The Roborock app also gets an update with a refreshed interface. It still has the same core features, but with a sharper look and some new additions like this map rotation feature. There's a lot to unpack, so let's get into it. This auto-empty dock is an add-on product to the Roborock S7, and I've asked Roborock if they have plans to sell this as a package like what other brands do, but they haven't committed to anything, so for now, you'll have to purchase this separately if you need the self-emptying feature. There are two color options, white and black, to match the S7 robot. Out of the box, the S7 base station comes in disassembled, but putting it together is easy by tightening these 5 bolts. Roborock made it easy to locate these bolts by adding these engraved screwdriver icons beside them. It also comes with an Allen wrench with a Phillips screwdriver head on the other end for securing the bolts, so you don't need extra tools to assemble. The S7 auto-empty dock measures around 15 inches tall and close to 18 inches deep, deeper than the Roomba and Yidi base station. Like the previous auto-empty robots I've tested, it has a ramp-style design where the robot sits, but one difference is the port size and where it connects. Whereas other self-emptying robots have dedicated ports in the robot's dustbin, Roborock does not, and utilizes the main brush roll inlet as the outlet port where debris flows through. Roborock says they did this so larger debris particles will fit, and I've tested it with different types of dirt with varying results, which I'll get to in a bit. One advantage of having the port at a cleaning nozzle is it also picks up any accumulation on a brush assembly, so it's one less thing to worry about for maintenance. Consumers will also get another dustbin specifically for the auto-empty base station. It's an identical design, but with a slot right here, which I think acts as a release valve so air flows smoothly when the base station engages. You'll have to remove this cover inside the dustbin port before attaching the new one. It's easy to spot with the label pointing to it. Another difference is that you can't open the new dustbin, except for this opening on top where the filter sits. It has a bag system with a 3-liter capacity that Roborock says will hold up to 8 weeks worth of debris, and it comes with an extra bag, so you're covered for up to 16 weeks. Users can turn on or turn off the auto-empty feature through the app. It also provides these 4 emptying modes at your disposal. I don't see any difference between these modes, and I'd keep it at the automatic setting for daily cleaning unless you have a big mess to clean up. One unique feature of the S7 auto-empty base station is its twin cylinder design versus other brands that use a single cylinder. This design isn't just for aesthetics, but has a practical purpose. The first cylinder houses 2 filters. Yes, you heard that right. The S7 base station has 2 filters to complement its bag system. Roborock prioritized filtration with their design and says it captures up to 99.99% of particles as small as 0.3 microns. It comes with a washable pre-motor filter and a HEPA-rated filter, a first of its kind, and it's not something you'd see in other brands. The second cylinder houses the bag, and as I've said earlier, it's a 3-liter bag, which is larger than the Roomba bags I've tested previously. But it doesn't have a sensor inside that notifies users if it's full, so you'll have to check visually at least once a month. Please note that the second cylinder is detachable for easier dirt disposal and cleaning. Plus, it has a sensor that notifies users if there's no bag. My preference would be a bag system for auto-empty robots since it seals itself when you pull it out, almost eliminating exposure to allergens. The Roborock app also has a fail-safe feature that disables the auto-empty system if you repeatedly empty it, protecting the vacuum motor from overheating. Other features include an integrated cable management, which are these hooks to keep wires out of the way, and these electrode cleaning brushes that clean the charging ports every time the robot docks. I tested how well the S7 auto-empty base station empties the robot's dustbin on several debris types and quantities. It's something new I'm experimenting with, but it's a good way to test its limitations. It didn't have any issues for daily messes like dust and hair strands, as it picked up nearly everything, even debris sticking on the top-mounted filter. Roborock told me that the port size would fit larger debris, so I tested it with Fruit Loops, and it didn't do well, clogging on this narrow area. While the larger port, in theory, will accommodate bigger items, there is a limit, so keep this in mind. Next, I tried it with larger messes and filled this room with quicker oats, as part of the coverage and efficiency test. This experiment pretty much filled up the entire dustbin, and it's something I wouldn't recommend you do since the auto-empty dock can't deal with this quantity. I tried to empty it twice, but it didn't get much. I did another big mess torture test, this time with a mix of debris like quaker oats, hair and dust, nearly filling the dustbin, and the base station was able to empty it after 2 tries. I tried it on a combination of sand and dirt I picked up vacuuming the sofa, which almost filled up the dustbin and left contaminants on the filter. The auto-empty dock picked up most of it and even cleaned dirt sticking on the filter. The last test I did was on hair. I scattered a good amount on this test area, and it picked up this much. The base station didn't have any issues picking up the contents and got nearly everything. It's something that pet owners should consider. These tests show that the S7 auto-empty dock is built on a solid platform. It does have its limitations with how much dirt it can handle, but realize that all self-emptying robot vacuums also have this limitation, so it's not unique to Roborock. I doubt you'll use this robot to clean this much quaker oats, but I do these torture tests to check the boundaries. The results on sand, dust, and hair prove that the S7 auto-empty dock is robust and works well on a variety of debris types. So is this dock worth the high price tag? It depends if you're willing to spend on it. Getting this makes sense if you already own the S7, as it brings a lot of convenience to the table. Buying the S7 and auto-empty dock combo will nearly cost as much as the Roomba S9 Plus. While the S9 Plus offers better cleaning performance, especially on carpet, the Roborock S7 isn't far off, capable of heavy-duty cleaning with its redesigned brush roll. Also, the Roborock app, in my opinion, will provide better user experience with more features such as invisible wall and more frequent updates. So it's a lot of value for what you'll spend. Let me know what you think about the Roborock S7 auto-empty dock in the comment section below. And if you have any questions, consider giving this video a thumbs up if it's been helpful to you. Subscribe and hit the bell icon for future reviews like this. Links are in the description for more information. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.